The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 20 and 21, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in December of 1966 in New York.
Trividya ma somapa putopapa. Yagai Vishya Sargating Sakhante Tepunam Ashadva Surendra Lokam Atnanti Vidyan Dividevo Hogyan. Now, Lord Krishna has described different types of transcendentalism. The first he has described about the Mahatma. Mahatma is a great soul. And their symptoms have been described, the satatam kirtanam mam. They are engaged 24 hours, 10% in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. Jatantasya virabhrata, and trying to serve the Lord very carefully with bhav. So they are first class transcendentalists of the great soul. Then, second class, those who are trying to understand the Supreme, the Absolute Truth, by identifying himself with the Supreme. As I am the Supreme. This I have already explained. This I am Supreme means I am part and parcel of the Supreme, of the same quality. So these people, these devotees, not exactly devotees, transcendentalists, they, doing that, find they are little more advanced, and if by chance they get association of another pure devotee, then he can understand that I am not Supreme, but I am the part and parcel of the Supreme. Then he met further advance, and the ultimate goal, as I have several times explained before you, ultimate goal is to know Krishna or the Supreme Lord. That is the ultimate goal. So this is direct method. The Krishna consciousness, which we are trying to popularize, this is direct method and just suitable for this age. As Lord Chaitanya introduced, Kalo nastiva 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 gati gandhaka. In this age of Kali, the age of quarrel and hypocrisy, this is called Kali, in this age, this is the simplest method and direct action. Just like in military art there is a word, direct action. So this is spiritual direct action. This Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. But because it is very simple, sometimes those who think themselves as very intelligent and advanced, they think, what they are doing, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. We are meditating, we are philosophizing, we are doing penance and austerity and following the rituals, so many things. So, practically, they are, according to Bhagavad Gita, they are not directly in touch with the Supreme Lord, but they have taken different paths as ahangraha upasana, thinking himself as one with the Lord, pantheism, thinking everything the symbol of God, and thinking the universal form as the Supreme in different ways. So anyway, all of them, the first class Mahatma and all these people, they are transcendental. They are trying to realize the Absolute Truth. Maybe in a different grade, but they are trying. And besides that, besides them, there is another class who are more or less can be called not transcendentalists, but materialists. And what they, that is described here, Pravidyamang Somapa Putopapa Jagdai Rishya Sargatin Parsante Te Punamma Shadasranda Lokam Ashtanti Dibjana Devabhogya. Devabhogya means this is with reference to the standard of living. As in this world we have got different standard of living, and it may be that your standard of living in America or Europe may be from material point of view very high, and standard of living in other country may be lower. Different standard of living there are. But in other planets also there are different standard of living. They are called Devabhagya. That standard of living we cannot imagine here in the moon planet and other Surendra Loka. In the Surendra Loka means where the demigods live. They are also human beings, but they are highly intellectual and their duration of life is very long and their standard of living is very high, most costly, we cannot imagine even. So, they are somapa. Somapa is a kind of beverage. Just like in this material world we have got different kinds of liquors. It is not intoxicating, but there is mention. Here in the Bhagavad Gita is also mentioned, somapa, somaras. And in Srimad Bhagavatam we get information that in the moon planet they also drink this somaras. But this somaras is not an intoxicant. It is a different thing. Here it is said, somapa putopapa. One who will drink this somaras, he will be freed from a sinful reaction. Just the opposite. Here, just like when we become intoxicated, we become addicted to so many sinful actions. It is somapa. When you drink somara, it is just the opposite. We become freed from all sinful reactions. So that somapa is recommended here also. So either they try to go to other planets, and or they manufacture here somapa, somara. Of course, at the present moment we have no such facility, but from Bhagavad Gita it is understood that there is a method. Anyway, the process is mentioned, described in the Vedic literature, Trividya. Trividya means Vedas. There are three kinds of knowledge in the Vedas, Trividya. Karmakanda, Upasana Kanda, and Jnana Kanda. Karmakanda means this, how we can adjust material happiness on material living very nice. That is called Karmakanda. And then Upasana Kanda. Upasana Kanda means how to worship the Supreme Lord or the demigod or different types of their demigods. The demigods are living beings like us. But they are very powerful. So, that Upasana Kanda, worship of different demigods, is also mentioned there in the Vedas. That is called Upasana Kanda. And Jnana Kanda. Jnana Kanda means knowledge, philosophical. So, therefore, Veda is known as Trividya, Trai. Trai means three kinds of knowledge there. So, the persons who are more or less materialists, they are not transcendentalists, they take shelter of these Vedic Trivida, three kinds of knowledge. And to prepare themselves to be transferred in other planets, they become free from all sinful reactions. As several times mentioned, that your standard of living in America is very nice. So others, people from other parts, they also try to come here and settle here. But you have got restriction, visa department, very restriction department. You do not allow. So similarly, if you want to go to the moon planet, then you have to qualify here. You have to obtain the visa. That is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. Janti devam pratar devam. Kitrin janti vitri vrata, bhutejya janti sutani, madjarino pi janti maam. So any planet, wherever you want to go, of course you may try to go there by Sputnik, but we have no such mention in the shastras that you can manufacture some machine and can go there. You have to qualify yourself. You have to qualify yourself. That's why in there is machine, jet plane. Still, you require a visa to enter into America or any other country. Similarly, even if you can manufacture some machine, although it is not possible, but you have to qualify yourself to be a resident in the better planet. So those who are after going to the better planets and sun planet, moon planet and heavenly planet, there are many. Sadguloka, Janaloka, Tapaloka, Mahaloka, they are in Sanskrit name. So here it is mentioned, Trividya Somapa Putapapa. They after preparing themselves to be transferred in other planets, they become free from all sinful reaction. The higher planet as you go, you have to become free from sinful action. The lower grade life and higher grade life in this material world means those who are proportionately less sinful, they are promoted in higher planets. But you cannot be free from sinful reaction in this material world. There will be some portion, some percentage. So the higher grade life and lower grade life means those who are proportionally greater sinful, they have got lower grade life, and those who have got greater pious life, they get higher grade life in higher planets. Brahmaloka, Jaraloka, Tapaloka. Tapaloka means those who have performed here severe penances and they are transferred there in Tapaloka. In Tapaloka, when there is destruction, annihilation of this material world, in Tapaloka there is no destruction. They get information, now annihilation has begun. There is great fire and they still feel that heat, and at that time they transfer themselves to the spiritual sky. That invention we have got. So jagvai rishya sargatim prathayante. So these materialists, anyone, even if you go to the higher planets, it's still your material. Even if you go to the highest planet, Brahmaloka, where the duration of life you cannot calculate, still there is death, the material plants. Birth, death, old age and disease, there is. So, in the Bhagavad Gita, we get all this information, where other planets are, what is the condition. Simply you have to know it from this book. Similarly, we have got information of the supreme planet, Krishna Loka, the planet of Krishna, where you can go. The Lord says, Jadgatyana nivattante tadbhama paramangama. The planet where going, you have no more to come back. Now these planets, these material planets, as it is mentioned here, Surendra Lupa, Surrender means highly qualified demigods, their planet. Surrender lokam ashnanti. Ashnanti means they enjoy. And what do they enjoy? Divyan, Vili, Deva, Vogyan. They enjoy godly comfort. Deva, Vogyan. Now, Lord Krishna says, then what is after? The after result is said here, Tetam bhuktya sarga lokam vishalam kine punne matya lokam vishanti. Evam trayi dharma anuprapanya gata gatam kama kama alavante. So those who are so materially attached, their business is that they qualify themselves to be promoted in higher planets, undoubtedly. And there, tetam bhukta sargulokam vishalam, and they enjoy life for a very, very long duration of life and godly facilities. That's called life. But kine punne masya lokam vishanti, then when they are pious, access of pious activity is finished, then they are again driven out from that planet, they come here. This material, I mean, the earthly planet. And again, they try here. Again, they try here by sacrifices or by other means to go there. So, Lord Krishna says, these materialists, they gatagatam kama kama labhanti. Sometimes up, sometimes down. This is going on. Sometimes up, sometimes down. Just like what is called that wheel, sometimes go up, the boys enjoy in this way. What is the name of that wheel? So it is something like that. Sometimes you go sarvaga, sarvaga, sarva jiva. Jiva means living entities, they have got a propensity to go. From here to there to here, that is there. Because they are living forth. They cannot stay at one place. That is not their nature. In this life also, you Americans, you try to go to India, the Indians try to come here or some other country. This is nature. In the birds, bees, everywhere. They want to transfer their own difference. So it is going on. So, the materialists who want to go to the higher planet by pious activity, they can go there. But they will have to come back again. But what is the idea of going there? The idea of going there is the materialists, they are always seeking a better comfort. There is no limit. Where is better comfort? In this earth also, people are trying to advance the material. Just like in your city, I see very nice building, they are being dismantled. Very strong, nice building. When I go to that chamber site, I see that one very nice building, very strong building. But you think that after dismantling this building, we shall prepare another skyscraper covered by nice glasses and you will be comfortable. That is the idea. You see? So, materialists, they do not know where their advanced of material civilization will be perfect. They do not know that. Nate vidu sarthata tinni vishnu. That perfection will never come. But they are after that perfection. Dismantling and building. And after 6 years, they will dismantle this building and prepare another kind of building. That will be, at that time, further material advancement will be there. So, this is going on. Gatagatam. Gatagatam means, what is called, stereotype. Everyone is going. The exact Hindi word is Dharyadhasa. Dharyadhasa. They call Dharyadhasa. Dharyadhasa means that the goat merchants, they're taking to the slaughterhouse. And they're going hither and thither. But if one goat enters the door, all the various, they will enter. Okay. So, because one has entered, but nobody will consider that he has entered the slaughterhouse. No, one has entered, therefore let us enter all. This is advanced. Or one has entered, therefore I must enter. I do not care where I have entered. That I do not know. So this is going on. Gata-gata. Gata-gatam kama-kama-ladante. Kama-kama means sense gratification. The sense gratification. But transcendental is, they have understood that this sense gratification process will not help me. This is called Krishna consciousness. One must understand perfectly well that these process of sense gratification, that will not help me. He is very intelligent. I have to search out something else, not this sense gratification. So long I have got a pinch of desire for sense gratification, I'll have to take this material body. And as soon as I have got this material body, then all the material miseries are along with it. So those who are serious about that I do not want any more, but we have become callous. We don't think that what is misery. But those who are actually in knowledge, those who want to live, those who want to have perfect knowledge, those who want to have blissful life, they understand that this material existence, either this Sargaloka or the heavenly planet or this planet or that, will never give me happiness. I'll have to, as Krishna informs herein, that Jadgatyana Nivartantita Dhamma Parama Mama, I'll have to enter the kingdom of God, the spiritual planet, where when I'll have not to return back again to accept this material body. That seriousness, one who has taken that serious attitude, they can actually perform this Krishna consciousness very nicely. But those are still under the impression that material advancement will make me happy, they are still under the spell of illusion. This planet, that planet, that planet, that planet, that planet. But in no planet, nowhere, you can have perfect peace of life. That's impossible. Therefore, those who are intelligent, those who are by God's grace, Krishna's grace, or by good association, one who can understand that this sort of life is not desirable, perform durabhuta with great determination and power in this life, so that jadgatyanam nivartante, I may be transferred into the Krishna lok planet, where going I shall not have to resort back. Now, the material says, all right, you do not know whether you are going or not. You are giving up this material enjoyment. You are simply living on chapati. We have got so many palatable dishes, and you are not enjoying this, you are food. So, to these poor devotees who are taking chapati, the Lord says very nice thing. What is that? Ananna sintayantamman jijana pajyupasati tesang nittari jittanam yogachimang mahamiyaham. Well, materialist, Mr. Materialist, you have to work very hard. But here the assurance is from the Lord. that those who are unflinching and 10% devoted in the transcendental service of me, for them I take charge of the maintenance. All comfort. Nityayitayam yogakshemam vahamyaham. Now this law is very important for the devotee. There was a great devotee. His name was Ananda Acharya. So when he was writing commentaries on this particular slope, but he saw that Tisham Nistarijitanam Yogakshemam Vahamyaham. The Lord says that I myself take the burden and take the load on my head and I deliver that to my devotees what they require. That they require. He doesn't require to go outside. I myself go and deliver the goods, whatever he requires. This is written here. Tisham Nityavijuttan. Those who are 10% engaged in the loving service of the Lord, Tisham Nityavijuttanam Yogakshemam Vahamaham. Yogam means what is required by him. And Kshemam means what he has got, he required to be protected. So these two things the Lord takes charge that I personally do. For whom? Ananda Sintanta Maam. Those who have no other thought than Krishna, Krishna consciousness. Ananda Sintanta Maam. Jidanapa Jupasate and engaged in that way. Always. He has no other business. Simply Krishna. For him, this thing, the Lord does. It is specifically mentioned here. Now, therefore, this is an encouragement. This is an encouragement by the Lord that do not think that because you are not trying for going to the other planet, you will be unhappy. You will have happiness. What is happiness? Happiness is within your mind. If you are assured of your peaceful existence, and the next time you are transferred to the supreme planet, the supreme place, then that is happiness. Not for trying life after life to adjust happiness. Here is an assurance. Now that's Arjuna Acharya. That's a nice story. When he was writing commentaries, he thought, how is that? The Lord will come himself and deliver the good? Oh, it is not. He might be sending through some agent. So he wanted to cut Bahami Aham. I bear the burden and deliver. He wrote in a way that I send some agent who delivers. So that Arjuna Acharya went to take bath. And in the meantime, two boys, very beautiful boys, they brought some very nice foodstuff, very large, in large quantity. And in India, there is a process to taking two sides burden on the bamboo, just like a scale. It is balanced. So these two boys brought some very highly valuable foodstuff and grains and ghee and all this. And his wife was there. And the boy said, my dear mother, Arjuna Acharya has sent this goods to us, to you. Please take delivery. And, you are so nice and boy, you are so beautiful boy, and he has given, and Acharya is not so cruel. How is that? He has given so much burden to you. And he's not kind enough. I was not taking, just see, he has bitten me. Here is Cain, Mark. His wife became very much astonished that Acharya is not so cruel. How he has become so cruel? So she was thinking, in that way? Then all life might get by if you come out and gain his shelter and no, I shall go because Arjuna says, him come, he will chastise us. No, no, you sit down, take food stuff. He prepared food stuff and then they went there. And when Arjunacharya came back, then and he saw that his wife is eating, because it is a system of Indian family that after the husband has taken the food, the wife will take. So they don't take together. After the family members, the boys and the husband is sumptuously fed, then the housewife takes. So Arjuna says, oh, you are taking food? Why is that? What is that? No. No, he did not. I am mistaken. Sorry. He says that you are, say, the wife says, Acharya, you have become so much cruel nowadays. What is that? Two boys, very nice boys, they brought so many food stuff. You loaded on their heads and they denied to take it and you have bitten them. I just said, no, I have never done this. What shall I do? Then you see this guy was such a nice, beautiful boy. Then the Arjuna understood that because I wanted that God does not deliver, so he has delivered this goat. And because I cut this alphabet that he does not give personally, so he has shown that beating mark. There is an incident in southern India of Jomuna Chaja. That story is there, of course. You may believe or not believe, that's a different thing. But here, the Lord says that I personally deliver. So, those who are in Krishna consciousness, those are actually busy in the matter of discharging their duties as a Krishna conscious person, they may be assured that so far their living condition is concerned, or their compass of life is concerned, that is assured by the Lord. There will be no hampering. Thank you.